All information are talking about a long war. So we are very worried. We are a non-for-profit hospital. We are famous for our burn center. We receive from all hospitals in Lebanon all the burn patients, patients who lost their eyes, who lost their vision.
Here at hospital, there is a lot of stress. Our staff, they express their worry. In the night, they are hearing the bombardment. It's very difficult time for us, very, very difficult time.
Our patients are civilian, not warriors or not from the militia of Hezbollah.
They are women and children.
We have a patient that he have the two limbs totally burned. He need bilateral amputation above knee, and he is in a critical situation. We have a child of 15 years old. He lost his three brothers and his sister. They are dead, and also his mother. And he is burned at 55%. Can you imagine the psychological impact in this patient? And maybe he will die also because of complication of burn. So almost all the patients that we are treating are in a severe situation.
We have to treat them without any support, really, any aid. And we have to do it by ourselves. We are replacing the government. And the treatment for burn patient is really very costly, very, very costly. We don't know how much we can continue to take care of them by ourselves. If the war will last, maybe we'll not be able to pay the salary for our staff. Yani, this is my first concern.
Because our burn center have only 9 beds, but in the war, all the beds are full, and we were obliged to increase the capacity to 25 for burn patients. So all our concern is about financing our hospital. When there is war, the elective work will decrease, and this will decrease our income. Financing this hospital with war, a government who is not paying, is very difficult, and there is no bank to make an overdraft for us. People are fed up with this situation. Lebanon is an extraordinary country, a beautiful country, a nice people, and a country that not deserve what is happening. We deserve peace. We deserve a good way of living with dignity and independence. We are seeking for peace and this crisis to end and this war to end.